Hey guys, Degan from PMTV UK.
Hey, I'm here with Mark from Pioneer DJ. How's it going, dude?
Very good.
Cool. And he has something very special today. Do you want to talk us through it, Mark? Let's go.
Yeah, let's do it. So we're going to show you the new Nexus 2 system. We're going to start with the CDJ. As you can see here in the top left-hand corner, first thing you're going to notice is the bright buttons. Nice colors here. So we went from 3 hot cues to 2 banks of 4. So now we have 8 hot cues total, and the way we record them is different. Instead of jumping into record mode, now we just find a blank hot cue slot. These are actually all taken, so let's delete these quickly. So touch once to record. Sorry, let's take that. That was a loop. Touch once to record and once again to launch. So it's nice and quick. So and then you hold this button here to delete. And another cool thing, so to get these lovely colors here, you just change the colors of your hot cue pad within record box, and everything will sync up upon export. The next thing you're going to notice here is our slip reverse switch in addition to our forward reverse. So it's a momentary slip reverse. So let's say you want to censor, you know, a curse word in a song. You can just touch it up, or for a cool effect, hold it down, and as soon as you let it go, the effect disengages. We brought back our 4-beat automatic loop, which is also an 8-beat automatic loop by holding it down for 2 seconds. And then every time you touch it after that, loop, cuts the loop in half. Moving on up here, you're going to see a nice color 7-inch full color touchscreen. So as you can see, you can scrub through your track here and access a feature called needle countdown. So we can bring it up to our breakdown here and find out that there are 5 bars until we get to that breakdown. Another thing we can do, our needle search is now on touch. So we got rid of the ribbon, and everything again is full touchscreen here. We can jump back and forth between our old and new phase meters there. We have a beat jump, which can jump 1 beat forward or 1 beat backward. You can quickly jump into loop mode here. Engage and disengage loops. One of my favorite features here, I'm going to jump to it quickly, is our shortcut. I call that the magic button. So it brings up this screen. And one of the coolest things we can do here is access a full QWERTY keyboard to search. So jumping back into our shortcut screen here, you could jump to all your playlists here and then access all your tracks and all your playlists just at once. Back to shortcut. You could change your quantized beat value now from 1 to half, quarter to eighth beat. You could change your waveform from RGB to blue. And you can also change the way your hot cue auto load settings. You can turn them on, turn them off, or use your record box indicated settings. Another feature we have is our track filter. So by holding this down, we can really dig and get specific about the tracks that we have. So we can search for tracks plus or minus 6% of 130 beats per minute in the key of C or related. You can see all your keys here. In the key of C or related, star rated 3, and color pink, orange, and blue. Or we can even change those to red, green, and purple. And now all the colors that meet that, all the tracks that meet that criteria will show up. You can dig even further and jump into my tag, which is right here. And all these would be set up within Rekordbox ahead of time. So you can say, all right, I want all tracks that are that have synth and, let's say, sub-bass situation. Let's say they're good for after hours. And all the tracks that meet these criteria are going to pop up in your track filter. So it's really a good way to dig deep within your music collection within Rekordbox right on the player. So now we're going to jump over to the mixer. First thing you're going to notice, dual sound cards. Fantastic for jumping back and forth between two DJs, either playing simultaneously or between DJ handoffs. MIDI on-off switches here. Obviously, your two mic controls up top. Parameter on the sound color effects, which enables you now to customize your sound color effects a little bit better. The color effects knobs are slightly larger, gives you a little bit of a better handle on them. Moving on down here, we're going to notice a second headphone input, which is an 1/8-inch mini jack, just in case you forget your quarter-inch adapter or lose it on the plane, as so many people do. Also good for two DJs playing at the same time. You can hook up two pairs of headphones at the same time. 4 phono inputs. So we have an input on each channel. Each channel has the same inputs. A and B sound cards, digital line phono, and a return aux, which we'll get into in a second. We added what I like to call a dummy light. Let's turn this down so we don't kill ourselves with volume. If you start to play a little too loudly and you start to clip that signal, the mixer's going to tell you, hey, buddy, you're clipping, turn it down a little bit. So it's kind of like the check engine light in your car. It's a little bit of a warning, like, hey, something's wrong. Let's tone it down a notch. Sound guys will appreciate that. We changed the crossover point on the low EQ knob. So basically, it cuts a lot less of the mid out than it used to. So before, when you were trying to just seclude a vocal and you're trying to kill all the bass, it would kind of cut a little bit of that lower end of the vocal out of it. Something else you're going to notice, our beat effects light here. What that does is that tells you which channel your beat effects are going to be applied to. A lot easier to indicate that now, or to notice that in a dark nightclub. We changed the channel fader curve. So now we have this middle setting here, which is a very gradual setting, which may remind you of a rotary mixer type feel. It's very good for long mixes. Jumping over now into the beat effects section, you're going to notice that we added a ping pong delay. We brought back the pitch effect, vinyl break effect, and added a helix effect. And what we removed was the send and return from this section. We brought it up here. We'll get to more. We'll get to that in a second. But one thing, let's say you have a ping pong delay going. Ping pong delays are fantastic, but they don't sound really good on the low end. So we're going to remove our low end. This is the effects frequency buttons. So you can actually select which frequencies your beat effects are going to apply to. So if you don't want to affect the bass, deselect the low button. So it's really cool. As mentioned before, we broke out the send and return feature. So now we have two ways to access it: our quarter inch jacks in the back, or our industry first digital send and return, which is why we have our iPad hooked up here. So we can actually send songs, or you send your music out into our RMX app. So now, we can actually access this. So again, that's industry first digital send and return. Now you don't have to just use the RMX 1000 app. You can use any type of app that supports audio through the Lightning port. Also here, I jumped over the X pad. We increased the size of the X pad. It's double the size now, so you can quickly jump between your timing. And also on effects like filter or flanger, we have the ribbon there. So this, you can change your modulation on the filter and on the flanger as well, and use the buttons here to change your timing. The one thing I can't actually show you is how good the sound quality has improved, or how much the sound quality has improved. We're going for a much warmer, richer, fuller sound out of this mixer than we got out of the 900 Nexus, and we totally knocked it out of the park. It's a much better sounding mixer. Full digital in at 96K, 24-bit, and full digital out, 96K, 24-bit via SPDIF connection. So it is a fantastic sounding mixer, and we're extremely proud of it, and we think everyone's going to love it.